The Ministry of Education has also pledged to build 3 12-seater toilet facilities for the school. I'm pretty sure that all the parents here are grateful to the government for extending free education to the senior high schools and thereby removing any barriers to education once attributed to cost. The elimination of this single barrier has doubled the enrollment, and we are very hopeful that St. Monica's will be among the first schools to benefit from the proposed expansion programs that will reduce the congestion and eliminate the infrastructural stress currently experienced. The 78th class, Nana Chairman, has already set the pace and created a momentum amongst other old students to help our alma mater, not only in the maintenance and expansion of infrastructures, but also to make St. Monica's a Category A school with an exciting and inclusive academic environment. To that end, our theme for this occasion is providing holistic education, not just a certificate. Holistic meaning a comprehensive education that gives consideration to the whole human being, spirit, soul, and body. We are spirit beings, we live in a body, and we have a soul. Our soul comprised of our mind, our emotion, and our will. Our traditional educational methodologies has done very well in educating our minds. Comprehensive holistic education develops our entire human being, exposes our hidden talents, skills, and passions, and sets us up to fulfill our callings. As a pediatrician, my knowledge in child development has helped me appreciate the varied and unique ways knowledge is processed, and how a holistic approach can enhance our natural skills, talents, and creativity, and thereby produce a well-rounded and successful adult. I believe the founders of this great school have this form of education in mind, because one of our very own old students, the late Professor Marianne Rapa Adi, once said, and I quote, "Our souls and bodies were developed at St. Monica's because instructions were mostly given by nuns." 40 years ago, we, the class of 78, applause. 40 years ago, we, the class of 78, left this campus with our certificates, unaware of the immense impartation in our souls and spirits as we engaged in the Christian discipline that founded this institution. An impartation that propelled us to pursue our God-given purpose and to use the benefits of education to glorify Him. It was impossible to attend a school named after Our Lady St. Monica's and not reflect her nature and character. A lady of great optimism and faith, whose effective prayer life not only saved her family from alcoholism, but also gave the Anglican Church St. Augustine, her beloved son. Our Lady did not have the structured academic curriculum and standardization that we had, yet she became an effective and extremely inspirational leader in the Anglican faith. She may not have a certificate of education, but today we are all proud Monicans, because one young lady identified her purpose that fully engaged her passion and devotion. Amen. As little women, you have a unique advantage of tapping into the natural leadership qualities given by God. Qualities like intuition, discernment, friendship, love, fairness, wisdom, faith, perseverance, and excellence. These qualities make women unique leaders. And we live in a country that promotes women leadership, and we have to take advantage of that. Your certificate may earn you a job and a position. Your character will maintain that job, but your wisdom and ability to provide solutions will promote you to the leader you were created to be. Leadership comes with responsibility, but the hallmark of all great leaders is their willingness to serve others. And that is what the nuns taught us, and that's exactly what the 78th class has exemplified these past 18 months. Today, we crown our service by presenting you a beautiful portrait of what you can achieve. The canvas of this portrait being Christ Himself, the rock on which the school was founded. We chose the colors of this portrait carefully and strategically. We invited the head of this great nation, His Excellency, President Nana Dudampa Akufo-Addo. We have a chief of staff here. We have ministers, rulers of our great tradition, educators, clergy, professionals from every sector, archbishops and bishops, parents, faithful friends, and family. Girls, look around you. This is your future, and this is what you can achieve. You can occupy any of these seats here and fulfill the responsibility, but do it with the spirit of Our Lady and Mother, St. Monica. Be passionate, girls. Persevere. Be optimistic. Be humble. Develop others. Serve humanity. And above all, glorify God. Give back to this school, and let's make this great nation much greater and stronger. You can achieve this as you loyally uphold our motto, each for all and all for God. Amen. Thank you.